Hello, in today's video I am going to be improving the LCD code from the previous video, but first I have created a Facebook page and a Twitter page. It will greatly appreciate it if you give me a follow and a like on those pages. If you have any suggestions on something you would like to see, feel free to drop a comment on any of the pages or a comment down below. A subscription is always appreciated. Let's go to the coding. Now the first thing we're going to do is declare all the function bits as defines. So we start here. As you can see, we have the increment and decrements and the data shifts and all the nice stuff over here. And we're just going to create some defines for them. First define that we're going to do is we're going to call it LCD underscore. Most of them are going to be tagged LCD underscore. And we are going to say increment. Going to uppercase that. IDE's shortcuts not working. One moment while I'll figure this out. Now through the magic of editing, I have added all the hash defines in. So we have LCD increment as 1. We have LCD decrement as 0. LCD shift as 1. No shift, 0. Display on off, 1. Whatever the value is that you can see in the data sheet over here. So we have all those values defined. Now for our port pins, we are going to define a new data line, which is going to be the LCD read, and that's going to be port B, because we are going to read the inputs from the LCD. Now we need a way to be able to flip between input and output on the LCD pins, so we define another line, call that LCD IO and bit flag. And that will be tris B. So we now have a macro that can change the port B from either being all outputs to all inputs. Then we need a busy flag pin, which we can just copy paste here. And that'll be port B RB7. So the most significant bit, which is the BF pin on the LCD. Now this will determine if the LCD is currently busy with whatever. So we have a way to check the state of the LCD. So now we already have our clock function, we have our command function, and now we can add in the commands one by one. So our first command will be clear. So we create the function called void LCD clear. And we pass it void parameters, then we just pass it LCD command, and we pass it 0x10 for the clear command. And then the next command, which is return home LCD and void LCD, we say home. Now this does get a bit tedious at a while, but trust me, it's better this way than having it like the previous code was. And that will be 02 as the command. And we have our first changeable parameter, which is entry mode set. We create another function, call it LCD entry mode set. We pass it two parameters, which is going to be uint8. Call it inc underscore decrement and uint8 shift. Now we take our increment variable. We say that is equals to its own value, shifted up by 1, and just for safety, we AND it with 0x02. Now this will move the variable into the correct position for what we want it to do. Then we take shift, so it equals to shift, and 0x01. Then the command will always start with 0x04, and then we simply just OR it with increment, and then shift. And that's the entry mode function. Then the next function, and so I'm gonna duplicate this, and we call that function LCD display. Let's call it control, and we pass that three parameters, so display on off. Then our next parameter will be cursor on off, and the last parameter will be cursor blink. Let's quickly format this. Now the base command will be 0x08, and then we simply just OR that with these parameters. And now we do the same as before. We first take our display on off, set it equals to its shifted value, shifted by 2, and then our safety is 4. We just repeat this line, change our values to shifted by 1, about 2 as the safety, and then we have cursor on off. And that's that function. Then the next function will be cursor or display shift. We'll just call that one void cursor control, and it will contain LCD command as well, and that will be 0x10 as the command. Then we just say cursor shift as a parameter, and then right left as the other parameter. And we do again the same, say cursor shift is equals to cursor shift shifted by x amount of bits. I will now correct that, so it will be 3, and then the next one will be 2 and 08 as our safety, and 04. And then we simply just pass these two parameters into our LCD command. And then the next command is going to be function set. Create another one, also call that function set. And we're going to pass it three parameters, the data length and the amount of lines we want and the font type we want. So those three variables, repeat LCD command. And then we just take the variables with their safety margins again. And we pass them in as an OR. Then we have the set GC RAM address function, and this is a more simpler one. So we just call the function CG RAM adder, and we pass it the address. We just call LCD command. The base command is 0x80, and we just pass it the address. I'll OR it with the address. Just give it a quick check compile. Alrighty, the compiler's happy. Okay, now we get to one of the more complicated functions. So the next function is to check if the LCD is busy with something. So we declare a uint 8 for our return value, and we call the function LCD busy flag, and it gets void parameters. So we declare a variable, which is adder. So this is going to be the address we are going to be returning. Then next we set the RS line low, and then we set the RW line high, because we want to read now from the LCD. Here comes the tricky bit. The LCD IOBF port needs to be set as inputs. So we use LCD IOBF equals to FF, so we set the entire B port as inputs, which you can see here, since we're using the TRIS register with it. That controls if we're using the GPIO as input or output. Then we place an infinite loop to check constantly if the LCD busy flag is high. So if it's not equals to 0, just break the loop. I'm not a big fan of using this while a permanent while loop, because things can go awry and brick your code or hang your code or whatever, but I'm not going to implement a timer into this. Then next, simply what we do is we read the B port, and then we end it with 7F. So we are not interested in what the bit flag is after it has gone low. So basically what we're reading is what the current address is in the LCD, and we have no interest in the most significant bit on the B port, because that's the busy flag and it's completely irrelevant to the address data. After we've read the address, we can set the entire B port as output, so 0x00, and then we flip back our RS and RW lines to normal function. So RS is 0 and RW is 0, and then finally we return the address value. So this function now basically gives you the ability to check if the LCD is busy and read whatever you have written last to the LCD. Then we have the last two functions, which is write RAM and read RAM. So we create another function, we call it LCD write RAM. We pass it data, our RS line. I can't remember RS now off the top of my head, and I'm not going to search through the datasheet now. And then simply all we do is we say the LCD port output is equals to data. So the lat B register is equals to the data we are putting in. And then we clock the data and wait for 10 milliseconds. And then our final function is going to be to read the RAM. So we create a function LCD RAM read. That returns a uint8. We create a local variable that's called data. We set our RS line to 1. We set RW to 1. We set the B port to be inputs. Then we clock the LCD, and then after we have clocked the LCD, we read. We seem to have made a mistake. Okay, let me fix this function quickly. Data is equals to LCD read. So the data is equals to the LCD read. And then simply what we do is we set the LCD back to the LCD data line back to outputs. We restore our RS and RW line to 0. And we return the address. And I should probably add a 10 millisecond delay here just in case the LCD does not like it when we swap the input output port so fast. Then we go to the LCD init from the previous tutorial video. Then we can go here. Then we can replace all these command functions with their specific command. The first initialize is function set. We take that, we enter in our three parameters that we used before. So we're going 8-bit mode, two lines, and a font 5x8. And after function set, we have display control. Take display control, we set the display off, we set the cursor, and we turn off basically the entire display. Then we clear the display. I seem to have made a mistake. All the functions need to move up by one. Okay, so after that's fixed, we have entry mode set. So we have the LCD incremented with no shift. And then we turn on the display at the end. So display on, cursor on, blink on. I don't think I want blink on, but I can change this at any time I want. And then the rest of the LCD code will be the same as the previous tutorial. So let's give it a quick compile. Okay, no building errors. And let's create a header file for it. So we delete all the code. And we change our safety header to LCD disp underneath as well. LCD disp. We make those capitals. And then what we do is the fun part. I should have actually been writing this in a header from the start. And I had the wrong main project selected. Let's just give that a quick compile. Oh geez, what the hell? Ah, I had a double declaration there. We just compile again. Also, it clears a void function. Get rid of the main there, which shouldn't be there. The warnings. Never called, never called, never called, never called. Those are happy. Those are not catastrophic errors. We can remove this hash include and just replace it with lcddisp.h. And then simply what we do is we take all our macros stuff, cut it, put it in the display.h. We take all our functions, cut that, and stick that in the .c file. So all the functions are over here, and it's complaining because I did not include it into main. We quickly grab the include from here, paste it, we try building again. What the hell is your problem? Really? Really? Okay, fine. We include the configuration bits into the .h, and now it should compile. Of course not. Oh, I don't want you there, I want you there. Oi! Oh, it's whining about implicit declaration. Okay. Just going to move the screen out. Now we just add in our function declarations. So our LCD clock, our LCD command, LCD clear, and I'll get back to you when I'm done with this. Alright, so all compiler errors and whatnot is fixed now. So basically I just added to a .h and a .c file. Why did I do this? Because the previous LCD code was unworkable for additional projects. So that's an improved version of the LCD code. A like, share, comment, and subscribe is always appreciated. Like I said at the start, any suggestions of what you want to see are always welcome. And as always, the code will be linked on my Git. Thank you. Have a nice day.